had the blues.
How do you like the blues, Lamar?
I love it. Love it.
When you hear the blues, tell me what you think about.
I'm going to talk to you while the band is playing behind you, because the man that I'm about to bring on publicly deserves some words said about him. For instance, the blues began originally in New Orleans of this country, and since its emergence as a musical form, it has been copied and imitated by artists who really don't understand its meaning. And I want you to know tonight that you are about to hear the originator who originally played it. His name is B.B. King. And as it is, he is the king of blues. Let's welcome B.B. King.
Thank you.
I've been downhearted, baby. Ever since the day we met, I say I've been downhearted, baby. Ever since the day we met. You know, our love is nothing but the blues, woman. Baby, how blue can you get? You evil when I'm with you, baby. And you are jealous when we're apart. You're so evil when I'm with you, baby, and you are jealous when we're apart. How blue can you get, baby? The answer's right here in my heart. I gave you a brand new Ford,
but you said I'm in a Cadillac.
$10 dinner, and you said thanks for the snack. I let you live in my penthouse. You said it was just a shack. I gave you 7 children, and now you wanna give them back.
Thank you.
How about one more for our bass? Rudy Eckells on the bass. Rudy Eckells. We thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We see this fellow standing over his lady, watching her sleep. He looked down at her. She looked good to him sleeping there. But he want to wake her up because he happened to be one of these guys that think that if he have to meet the man every morning, that's go to his job, his gig, or whatever you want to call it, then he figured that his lady should meet him in the kitchen to fix his breakfast every morning when he go to work. But she disagreed with him. You see, he happened to be one of these guys that don't know anything about women's lib. He don't read the papers unless somebody else is reading them. On his way to work, he hardly turn on his radio, and he don't care much about TV, so he don't know anything about women's lib. But his lady feel that if he don't know anything about women's lib, she's fed up with his, you know, his lip, so she gonna straighten him out this morning. So we see him as he looked down at her again, and he shake a little. Thank you. But she don't open her eyes. Look at her and he shake a little harder. Thank you. But she still don't open her eyes. Now it's getting a little late. My man is usually punctual on his job. Kind of like these people I got in the back there helping me out back there. So he believes in being on time and being heard when he's supposed to be. Right on. So he can't stand it much longer. He don't want to be late this morning, so he shake her a little harder. Thank you. And then we see her open her eyes. When she opened her eyes looked like they could cut him. So he backs across the room. He also noticed that from the color of her eyes, he could light his cigarette. Kind of red, you know. So he just stand over there looking at her. Then he noticed from the expressions on her face, she began to realize that she's at home. She was already angry because she had to come home last night. Then to wake up and look in his face make it just that much worse in the morning. So as she lay there trying to figure out whether she should tell him off while laying in the bed or should she get up and do it, then all of a sudden she remembered that one day one of her friends told her that she said, "I do." She don't remember it, but if they say she said it, I guess she did. So we see her crawl out of bed. When she crawled out of the bed, we see her start making it for the kitchen door. My man trailing along behind her like a well-trained puppy. Then we see her put her hand on her hip when she get near the kitchen door. And she looked back at him and say, "I know a man that's greater than you'll ever be." And he get up every morning and fix his own toast and he put peanut butter on it. And as far as I'm concerned, you ain't gonna never be president of nothing. My man don't mind that too much. But as she start on through the door, she looked back at him and say, "And as far as love is concerned, baby, you are over the hill." Now that hurt my man. Because see, my man haven't been playing around on his lady. See, if he hadn't been playing around on her, all he'd have to do is go over to one and say, "Hey, am I really as bad as she say I am?" But since he haven't been playing around on her, he don't know whether she's telling the truth or not. And that really hurts when you ain't got no defense, you know. And then she looked back at him one more time kind of give him the eye, you know, and said, baby, as far as love is concerned, honey, the thrill. And they come at odd hours, like just before we have to go to work in the morning. And they usually leave just as he's coming home in the evening. But you see, what she didn't know, that a jealous husband, or should I say a jealous man, is worse than the CIA. He don't miss nothing. And see, all the days that my man was supposed to go to work, my lady didn't know that he had sick days coming. And he used up some of them watching his house, you see. But she's determined to straighten him out this morning. She look at him and kind of give him the eye that ladies usually do, you know, kind of look at him, grit her teeth a little bit, you know. And this is what she said. All of your affection is gone, baby. And your love is growing cold. She said, all of your affection is gone, baby. And your love is growing cold. Hey, and I've got a new story to tell you this morning, baby. One that ain't never been told. My man couldn't take it no more, and then he looked at her, and this is what he said. I went to work the other day, but I thought that I'd double back. And that car I saw sitting in the front of my door, it looked like a brand new Cadillac. Hey! And I ain't got now, now, baby. I think you've been cheating on me. I believe to my soul, baby, that you've given me some outside help that I don't think I really need. The iceman came by this morning, and you know he didn't leave no ice. The postman came by later, baby, and it didn't even ring twice. Hey! I think you're cheating on me, baby. I think you're running out on me. I believe to my soul, baby, that you've given me some outside help that I don't think I really need. Now I want you to tell the ice man, the next time he better leave some ice. And I want you to tell the postman, he better ring more than twice. And when I come home from work in the morning, it better still be some groceries on the shelf. And I want you to tell that slick insurance man that he better write some insurance on his head. Hey! I think you're cheating on me, baby. I think you're running out of me. I believe to my soul, baby, you're giving me some help.
Thank you.
you're gonna be so
and she could be jiving too. Hey, nobody loves me but my mother. And she could be jiving too. So now you know why I act so funny, baby. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We do hope that you've been enjoying a little bit of it up to this point. Thank you. I'd like for you to meet the members of the group. Starting at my left, put a light over that organ, please. At the organ? Over a little further, yeah. Raise your hand up, me. There he is, there, yeah. That's James Toney. How about a hand for him? James Toney. Thank you very much. On guitar, little light on him, the guitar, right. One of the senior members of the group, he's been with me 5 years. Make him happy, please. Milton Hopkins, guitar. Milton Hopkins. Thank you very kindly, thank you. On bass is one of the new members, Rudy Eckells. Make him happy, Rudy Eckells. Thank you, Rudy. Thank you very much. On the drums, another new member of the group, John Starks, better known as Jabo. Make him happy, please. Jabo on the drums. We thank you. And now we go to my far right at the piano. Put a little light on him there, yeah. And ladies and gentlemen, he's next to the, right close to the state of New York. He comes from Massachusetts. He's another senior member of the group. He's been with 6 years, so I think you should give him a special hand, you know, close up. Ron Levy. Ron Levy. In fact, he lives in New York now. That's the reason why I was... We try to show off all the guys now. Alto sax. Sorry about that. We'll go to the trombone first. Put a little light on him there. Ladies and gentlemen, I've introduced him around the world. There's Little Joe from Chicago. Make him happy, please. 4 years with us. Joseph Burton. Little Joe! Thank you very much. Thank you. Alto sax, he's been with us 3 years. Cato Walker III. Make him happy. Cato Walker. Wait, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. On tenor sax is the veteran of the group. He's been with me 8 years. Valentino the 35th. Ladies and gentlemen, Bobby Forte. How about it for him? Make him happy. Bob? Wait, thank you. Thank you so much. On trumpet and our conductor, ladies and gentlemen, 4 years with me. Make him happy, please, Mr. Eddie Rowe. Lay it on him. Eddie Rowe. Wait, thank you. Thank you so much. And yours truly, my guitar, Lucille. Thank you. Thank you very much. About 29 years professionally, my name, B.B. King. I thank you so much. We do thank you, and it seemed like to me that I'm sorry you happen to get seats like that. I can't help it. They got all the lights over here. See, now you can see me and I can't see you. I'm sorry about that. Don't blame me. I didn't have nothing to do with it. But thank you for being with us. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. I'd like to dedicate just this little bit to these ladies, whoever this is, that having such a problem back in the back. I'm so sorry. We'd like to sing just a little bit for you. Someone really loves you. Guess who? Someone really cares. Guess who? Thank you. on, sing it with me.
I like to live the love I sing about in my song.
Put a little more of that in.
I like to live the love I sing about.
I can't hear you.
In my song. I like to live the love I sing about.
Right on.
In my song. Say it loud one time for me.
Still clapping. Wasn't it mean? Come on. B.B. King, the Blues King. Come on, New York. Come on out, B.B. One more time. Felt the spirit during that session. They've worked hard for you. They've worked hard for you. The show is not over yet. The show is not over yet. We have more coming your way. So if you only be patient, momentarily we'll be on once again.